guys, it's me Chiku from Chiku Study Corner, and today I'll be dealing with the Chapter 1 of English Class 12 at CBSE, that is the last lesson. This chapter is the first lesson of our textbook of Flamingo, that is our core textbook. Okay, we have two textbooks, that's Vista and Flamingo, so this is the first chapter of Flamingo. Okay, so this chapter is divided into two parts. I'll take the first part today and the next will be continuing on the next day. So, without any further ado, let's get into the chapter. So, the last lesson is written by an author named as Alphonse Daudet. He lived in the year of 1840 and died in the year 1897. Okay? He was a French novelist and also a short story writer. Let's learn about the background of the story. Why and when was the story written? The background of the story is in the time of the Franco-Persian War. What happened in the Franco-Persian War? The Franco-Persian War was in the year between 1870 to 1871. In the war, France was defeated by Persia. And what happened? And therefore, Germany took control over two districts of France. That was Alsace and Lorraine. Okay? The two districts, which are they? Alsace and Lorraine. Now, Alsace and Lorraine is under the control of Germany. So, now, the German officials, the German head told that there won't be French lessons anymore in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. Instead of French, that would be German that is taught in the schools. Okay? So, this story deals with the experience or the last lesson of our narrator. Okay? His last French lesson. So now, before discussing about the chapter, before giving you the summary of the chapter, I'll be telling you about the most important characters. There are two important characters in the chapter. The first one is our narrator himself, Little Franz. His name is Little Franz. And then we have what his teacher, M. Hamel, his French teacher at school, M. Hamel. So the two people are Little Franz and M. Hamel, okay? So now we'll discuss about the theme and sub-theme. The theme is the pain inflicted by people of a territory whose territory has been conquered by someone else, and the conquerors doesn't allow to learn or study in your own language or speak in your own language. Okay? That is the theme. The sub-theme is the bond between the teacher and the student, and also the perspective of a teacher and a student towards teaching and learning. Okay? So that is the talk about the theme and sub-theme. Now let's learn the chapter. So, the summary of the story. The story is narrated by a French boy called as Little Franz. So, he was very naughty, he was lazy, but he was sensitive also. He loved play. He hated French and also his teacher M. Ham. So, what are the points that I told you? That this is a French boy named Little Franz, that he is our narrator. And what is it? He is lazy, he is naughty, he loves playing. Then what else? He loves playing and he's so attached to nature also, okay? So he loves playing, and then what? He dislikes French and he dislikes his teacher too, okay? So let's learn more about the chapter. So this, now Franz has to go to school one day, and his teacher M. Hamel told that that the students would be questioned on participles, and he was in a lot of fear of getting scolded, because he didn't even know the first letters of participle. Okay? So he was so scared. He never wanted to go to school. When he looked out of the window, he saw that the day was so bright, the sun was shining, it was so pleasant day. The birds are chirping in the woods, the Persian soldiers are drilling near the sawmill, etc. He found that way interesting than going and writing the participle exam that is being conducted. So, but what he did is he resisted himself, and then he hurried to school. On the way to school, near the town hall, he saw the bulletin board. Okay? So, what is the bulletin board? What is the speciality of it? Bulletin board is a place where all the bad news is, the lost battles, what all else, demands of the commanding officers, etc. used to be put up. So, without him stopping there, he was just thinking, what might be the thing now? Why is there a lot of crowd? When he was walking, the blacksmith watcher with his acquaintance, what did he do? He asked our narrator, Don't run, Baba. Don't run, child. The word over there is bub, okay? B-U-B. Bub means kid, okay? Don't run, bub. You don't have to rush because you will reach in school with a plenty of time. Because it was, I think it was, he was mocking him maybe, yeah? So, now he reached school. When he reached school, usually the school is actually a place where there's a lot of hustle and bustle. Usually there's a lot of noise which could be heard outside on the street. Okay, usually the tables are being pushed, pulled, closed, opened. Children reciting their prayers and their chapters, everything. If you had to listen to something, you should have to close your ears. It was so loud. But this day was so unusual. It was so quiet as a Sunday morning. Because Sunday you will go to school. School, there's no one, so it's quiet. It was same as that. Okay, so like he was planning to get into class. He was planning to sneak into class without his teacher's notice. If there's a lot of sound and hustle, how will the teacher notice? He can jump into the chair and then sit down. Teacher won't notice. But the situation was not that. He had to go and open the door and then go and sit. So he went there, he opened the door, he went inside. And he found that it was so unusual. His teacher didn't scold him for being late. He just asked him, go sit in your place, little Franz. And also, we were about to begin without you. That's the only thing he told. So, Franz was confused. And Franz hurried and sat down in his place. After that, he noticed that his teacher was dressed in his best attire. He was wearing a green coat with a frilled shirt, black silk cap, etc. So, seeing that, he doubted, why is this? Usually, his best attire was only on the days of inspections and prize days. So, what was special today? That was what rushed into his thoughts. Okay? So, next is, now what he noticed was, he saw that the villagers were sitting behind. Usually, the benches behind was vacant. Now, there was the villagers who were sitting behind. They were so quiet. They were sitting as, like a student. Okay? So, there was the mayor, the Hasa, the other village men, etc. They were sitting there. So why was this? This was because they were paying tribute to the 40 years of sincere teaching, and also they were showing their protest, or they were showing their love towards their country. So now, I think you didn't get my point. I'll get to the point. Then, I told you they were paying tribute to the teacher M. Hammond for his 40 years of service. When do you pay tribute to a person? It's usually when it's a resignation or something. So, this was the last lesson that M. Hamill is going to deliver. Because when M. Hamill came to school, he told the students that this was his last lesson. He announced that it was his last lesson and there won't be any French classes anymore. After that, what happened? He told them about the new rule. What was the new rule? That German would be the next subject. You won't have French from the next day. New masters would come and teach you German. And French is over. This is the last French lesson. Now no more French. Don't worry about French. Okay? So, since it was his last lesson, he wanted everyone to listen to him attentively. So he told them, listen to the class attentively. This is the last class, etc. So, now our little Franz, he fell in love with the subject. He started falling in love with the subject. He started liking his teacher too. Okay? So, that is what is happening over there. I told you he hated French and he hated his teacher equally. Now he started liking them. The next one is, they started telling about that, the chapters and etc. So, now it was time for the teacher to take people for reciting the chapter. When it came to the chance for Franz to recite. When he went there and when he was reciting, he messed it up all. He didn't recite it correctly. There were so many mistakes. So what did M. Hamill do? He didn't scold him. Instead, he blamed himself for not allowing him to learn. He blamed his parents, he blamed his teachers, etc. And he asked our little Franz to get back to place and sit. Okay? So this is all what I'm dealing with. The chapter of the first part. It's only the first part. There's a second part coming. So I hope you might have understood it. If you have any doubt, please do a comment in the comment box below. If you understood it and liked it, please give my video a huge thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you're new to it. And also, share this video to your other friends too. So see you on my next video. Till then, bye-bye.